So one of the things I get asked about is how to control the start and stop of the weld. The way I would interpret that question is, if I've got a long weld and I need to stop, say adjust my rod, go to the bathroom, whatever it is, come back, how do I make it so that you can't really tell that there was a start and stop in the weld because it's just not pretty? Well, first thing you have to do is control the shape of the puddle. Now if you look at this piece of metal here, you see a fine weld. Structurally, nothing wrong with that, but the pedal's laid over really, really far. So it's not as easy to control the consistency. What's the easiest shape to control for us? Doing the weld. It's gonna be a circle. That's what leads to that stacked dime or row of nickels look everybody always talks about. So let's figure out how to make that circular bead. I've set the welder to about 85 amps, or I set it to 85 amps, not about out. Anyway, this piece of metal is a little under an 1/8 inch thick, and it's mild steel. This is stainless, and it's about 1/16th wall, so that's where 85 is good. So one thing you are going to need in order to make that perfectly round puddle, is a pedal or a slide knob so that you can go from 0 amps to whatever you set your ceiling amperage at. For example, 85 amps where I'm at now. That's very important because you're gonna need to do a lot of things. They're gonna have to work in concert to make that round shape. Let's get started. Now the type of weld I've chose for demonstration purposes is a fillet weld. This is the easiest weld to make look good. And notice the angle of my torch. It's pretty much straight on. That means it's not laying like this or like that, and that's what's gonna help me make that round shape, going straight into it. Here we go. So the first thing I'm gonna do, strike the arc, bring the heat in real slow, and basically just make my first circle. Add the filler material, and now I'm gonna back out. Notice I pull out real slow, and I let the gas sit there and flow on the weld. That's gonna help with stainless to make that rainbow color that everybody likes. So I've got my first circle. And bring in the second. So I'm pushing the torch in, then I'm letting off the gas, pushing it in. And when I mean letting off the gas, I mean the pedal. I'm letting off, pushing in, letting off, pushing in, letting off, pushing in. And then I'm just gonna let the gas cool the weld, like always. So the next thing to consider is my overlap. Since I've got circles, do I want to overlap at 50%? That's what a lot of people say. Well, 50% is almost a little bit too much exposure on the last puddle. That's where the circle starts to come around and crown again, and I can see where I started and stopped. So I'm going to back that puddle up to about 35 to 40%. It'll make it look like a 50% overlap, but really it's not. So here we go. I'm going to start in the dead center of this next weld, and back the torch up a little bit, add the filler, and go on and on at about 35 or 40% overlap. Make that nice round puddle, then back out a little bit. Bring in the heat till the puddle is round, then back out a little bit. It's a lot like being a drummer in a band. It's all about rhythm. It's not quite as sexy. You won't get as many girls, but at least you'll know how to glue stuff together well. This is where that torch angle comes into play once again. After I've laid down a couple of welds, I have to stop and adjust my body, adjust my arms to keep the torch angle the same. If I don't, I'm gonna start getting a weld that looks like the one I showed you earlier, which is fine, but it's not that pretty row of nickels look that everybody talks about. So I'm able to get about 4 of these little guys down, and then I gotta change my position. So it takes time, but if you wanna make something pretty, one of the sacrifices you have to make. Another thing to consider if you're trying to keep this looking pretty is where you introduce the fill rod at. Keep it at the front of the pedal so it gets melted away. If you bring it in on the side, for example, it'll leave a little tail and you'll know exactly where you were. And check that out. Even though I've made several start and stop points because I had consistency in torch angle and movement, it's very hard to determine where those points are. Now let's back up and come to the other side of this weld and I'll show you how to end it nicely. This was my old starting point. Now if you imagine me welding all the way around the pipe, at one point in time I'm gonna have to stop, like I mentioned. And that, just make as pretty of a circle as you can by just stopping right there, bringing your heat back real slow. And if you're really picky, I mean only a keen eye is ever gonna be able to point that out. Put it somewhere where no one can see it, like on the bottom of your header, for example. And if somebody still gives you grief, sounds like they need a good old-fashioned punch in the face. Until next time, I'm Jared Zimmerman. I'll still be Jared Zimmerman next time, too.